So, before we leave embodiment design, I would like to outline two important phases of embodiment design, that is selection of material and selection of manufacturing processes. These two phases are very important, and it is very very complex one, because you need to have a lot of expertise and deep knowledge on material science and manufacturing processes if you want to select an appropriate one for the component you are going to manufacture. So, here I would like to give an outline, but I leave you to further dig on to these subjects to further develop your key skills on selecting materials and manufacturing processes. So, this concept has been taken from these graphs, have been taken from this reference. And here, if you look at these graphs, these are all called bubble chart or Ashby's chart. So, they were developed by Professor Mike Ashby for selecting the materials. So, what these graphs are saying, so that's the point now. So, here these graphs are plotted between two important properties, any two important properties of materials. One is here, if you look at the x-axis, you have the density, and in y-axis, if you have the Young's modulus. Okay, but here you have a lot of bubbles, or shapes, or regions, or envelopes, you can say anything. So each envelope is defining a group of material. Here, this green portion represents the foam, and this brown portion, the red portion represent the metals and composites, ceramics, polymers, elastomers, like that. These are all group of materials. Okay, so what you can infer out of this graph? That's the question. Say you would like to have a material for a component of your design. With a rigidity or Young's modulus of 10 to the power 2, say. So you can also have defined your weight of your component. Weight in the sense, you can also put it in other words like density. Say you have a constraint of density around 1000. Okay, 1000 or between 1000 to 1500, say something like that, very close to that. Okay. So in that case, what you can do, you have two values in your hand. Young's modulus should be around this value and density should be around this value. So you can map over here. So what is the material that is available for the required property that I have? So here, if you come like this, and you can draw a line, vertical line from the density value that you would like to have. So it will hit one point, right? The point may lie at any envelope. Say if it is lying over here for this case, say this is 1500 and you are coming from 10 to the power 2 and it hits over here, so you may select any one of the composite materials. There are a lot of composite materials. Okay, so your rough option may be composite material, or if you do not have any constraint on weight, then you can further come on ceramic, or you can also come to the metal region. If the weight is a big constraint, then you have to stick onto the x-axis values as well. Okay, so now if you are deciding that you would like to have composites, in the composite family, you will have number of materials. So you can look at this graph. This is next level graph. So where they have also defined some particular materials or sub-classified materials in the family of materials of this case. Okay, here if you look at this composites, you have here FRPs, GFRPs, CFRPs, like carbon fiber reinforced polymer or glass fiber reinforced polymer. So you can choose anything you would like to have. So similarly, in all the other material groups, you have sub classifications. If you look at metals over here, you have tungsten alloys, you have copper alloys, you have lead alloys. You have zinc alloys and nickel alloys, steels, titanium alloys, like that. Okay, so even in the metal category, if you want to choose, you can also choose, right? But it only depends on the property that you are comparing, either Young's modulus or you may take strength. So in the next graph, you can see here instead of Young's modulus, you have strength value in the y-axis, in the x-axis you have the density. Right, so you can have the same comparison, and you can have which material has the required strength value. So I have this much strength and this much density in the sense, you can select a particular group of material. So this is a level 2 of the same graph, which means some sub classification of materials will be represented as some micro envelopes inside the big envelope. Okay, so this is one of the very essential and very beautifully represented concept to select the materials. And here also you can have the graph for thermal properties against thermal conductivity and thermal expansion. So I would like to have thermal conductivity of this value and thermal expansion of this value. Then you can look which group of materials are available in that category. So this is what you can have out of this bubble chart. You can have a number of properties mapped against cost as well as density, because we would like to have low cost materials or optimum cost material and optimum weight material. So the properties usually will be plotted against density, or property will be plotted against cost. So you can select the material for economy and optimum weight. So this is what the rough outline about selection of material, but this is not only enough for selecting a particular material. It is only helpful for overall selection of the material. So if you want to select a further particular grade, in for example if you are taking carbon alloy, or in the carbon alloy which grade you would like to have, either C30 or C45 or C60, so that depends. So you have to further have the metallurgical knowledge and experience to select the grade of material. Just some are good for welding, some are not good for welding. So if you are going to weld, then which material you have to choose. Okay, there is also strong interconnectivity between the selection of material and manufacturing process, because you should also check the manufacturability of the material. So if you are going to cast a material, so the material which you are going to select over here should be castable, or if you are going to forge it, it should be forgeable. Okay, some are not. So you have to have that in-depth knowledge for selecting the material and manufacturing process. So maybe if you are a beginner, you may get an idea from experts, or you may get an opinion from the experts after doing the selection process, or you can also invite the experts to have a brainstorming session to select the material manufacturing process for your product. Okay, so this is one of the important phase. And if you look at the manufacturing process which you have to select, as I told you earlier, manufacturing process and material selection are strongly interconnected. Okay, so you may have some constraint in manufacturing process. Like if you look at the diagram, this particular image, in this image you have a complex part, right? So this complex part cannot be manufactured in any other methodology, like forging or welding, like that, because it is so complex. You have to only go for, a lot of details are also there, so you have to go for only casting methodology. Okay, so complex geometries can only be manufactured, curved structures can only be manufactured using casting technology. And if you want to have good mechanical property, if you look at this connecting rod over here, so this connecting rod used to take lot of load in a cyclic manner, in a fatigue manner. Okay, so it requires lot of mechanical properties, like it requires good strength and fatigue strength. So you have to go for a forging type of manufacturing process, whereas you have the alignment of grain structure in a single direction, which will enhance the mechanical properties of the product. Okay, so this particular product, which is undergoing for a rigorous mechanical loading, it can be only manufactured by using forging process, because you need good mechanical properties. And also if you look at this image, you have a big beam, a column, and they are all welded. So this much big structure cannot be manufactured using other technologies. Maybe this plate may be casted, but other, if you want to build up this beam or column, you need to use welding process. You have to weld along the path. So for low cost also, and also large structures can only be manufactured using welding process. And additive manufacturing, you may look at this structure for reducing the weight, and small and complex geometries can be manufactured using additive manufacturing. It is not full-fledged manufacturing process nowadays. So it is under development. Some industries have adopted, but still it is not into the production, industrial production fully. So it has to be kept. And if you look at these three processes, they have their own limitations. So either complex geometry or good mechanical property or kind of structure you want to manufacture. So you have to have the requirement. So which one you would like to have? Okay. Based on that, you can decide the manufacturing process, and you can also recheck your material selection based on the manufacturing process you have selected, whether the material you have chosen is adaptable for that particular manufacturing process or not. That you should ensure. That's very important. So these two phases are very important in embodiment design, and they are strongly interconnected. It requires a lot of expertise and expert advice.